Hello, friends. My name is Alex Greckis, and I want to welcome you to the Finding Lost Civilization series. Today, I'm at a place called Swallow Rock, located in Fresno County, California. Now, the fantastic thing about this great, giant boulder outcrop is that it contains several panels of archaic petroglyphs. I'll tell you, this is going to be a fun journey, and I invite you to come trek with me. Well, friends, here's another view of Swallow Rock. This is the back end. Now, this boulder, this rock, is known as a blue schist rock. And this rock was favored by the ancients because it's a soft rock. It could be easily polished, easily carved upon, and they were using this type of stone to create amulets and charm stones. But let's take a look. I see something right over here that's really fantastic. Look at this over here. Now, first of all, let me show you this right here. This is the natural color of the blue schist here. It's almost aquamarine type bluish green. But let me show you this right here. See this right here? Look at this. Can you see the shine right there? Yes, it's just beautiful. I'll say, look how shiny it is. Again, you can see right over here, there's been a piece broken off. It's thought that possibly this large boulder outcrop was an area that was mined, okay? It was actively mined and used. But right over here, which is absolutely fantastic, you can see where it's been rubbed, so to speak. But let me show you something around the corner over here. All right, this is the boulder right over here. Look at the view. Isn't this absolutely fantastic? I'll tell you, this is really a joy to be. Oh my God, look, I can't believe this, friends. Look, look at this right here. Look at that right there. Can you see it? Look at that. That's an ancient petroglyph. My goodness, this boulder is covered with them. They're subtle. They're subtle, but they're here. Let me show you something right over here. Can you see this over here? This is a series of peck marks. Again, this was placed here by the ancients. Oh my goodness, look at this over here. Look at this symbol right over here. I'm telling you, friends, this looks like the top of a peyote button. Look at this. It's circular with a center area right where my finger is and then subdivided, okay? I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, possibly 6 angles cut to the center, like the spoke of a wheel. Now this petroglyph resembles what a peyote button looks like from the top. And this would have been used perhaps by the shaman. Look at this right over here. This is what's known as a cupule. Let me see if I can see any others. But right on top of here, look, it's full of peck marks right here. All right, let's step back. Let's get a long view, so to speak. Let me see what, oh, look at this right over here. Again, very subtle, but these are scratch marks, engravings put there by the ancients. Let me see again if we can see any more over here. Okay, back to this spot over here. This is absolutely gorgeous, my friends. This is a beautiful petroglyph. Oh, look, right over here is another cupule. And right next to it, look, there's a bunch of peckings over here. I can't tell what the symbol is, Oh, here's some graffiti, EJP, and looks like SM over here. But right over here, you can see a bunch of peck marks. Again, this was done by a hard stone. Look at this right over here. Can you see this? These are scratch marks, and again, some peckings over here. Look at this over here. Look at these scratch marks. And again, you can see scratch marks and peckings right over here. My goodness, look at this over here. Scratchings here. And here's another series of initials, graffiti. It looks like either J or RB 0284. So this is 1984, I believe. But again, look at this right here. Unfortunately, this here, graffiti, went over this ancient scratch marks over here. Okay. Believe it or not, this is a petroglyph style. And they're called archaic because they're very ancient. And as I said, their meaning has been lost in time. The early petroglyphs, the early paintings look like this. They're lines, scratching, lines that we call curvilinear, circular patterns. Look over here. I'm going to go up here and look at this. Here's a pecked circular pattern. Okay, here's another one with a line, a pecking through it. This is a fertility symbol. It's supposed to represent the vulva. And again, over here, look at this. There's another circular area right over here. And this whole boulder, look at the peckings right here. You can see them all across this boulder. My goodness. Again, there you see the scratch marks. Now, you know what this is? If I'm looking at this right over here, we have several different styles. Some of these peck marks were made after the scratch. For example, here's a scratch mark, and then right in the center of the scratch line, right over here, is a peck mark. And so what we have here is what we call superimposition. In other words, succeeding cultures put their symbols on top of symbols placed there by previous cultures. Now I'm looking up over here, and I think I see something over here. Let's take a look. Well, again, a bunch of peck marks. There's the circular pattern right there. I tell you, we're very lucky to have been able to find this, because if the sun were directly on this boulder, they would be very difficult to spot. Well, this is the area that we just looked at over here. And what I'm going to do is, as I said, at one time this was one large boulder, but seismic activity probably broke these boulders apart, time and age. We're going to go up over here and see if we can find any symbols. So this is really exciting. I'll tell you, these archaic symbols are very hard to spot because they don't have necessarily a recognizable image. In other words, it could be abstract wavy lines. So unless you're specifically looking for that, you could easily bypass the petroglyph. So anyways, as I'm walking here, again, I'm going to come in close. This is the natural topography right here. This is what the natural area of the stone looks like. As you can see, it doesn't have this high polished patina look as we saw in the other area. So we're going to go slowly. There's a lot of reflection off of this, but I'm sure that there are symbols here placed by ancient man. Oh my goodness, look at this right here. Can you see it? I can, because I've already seen a few of them. My eye is acclimated, so to speak. Look at this right here. That is a petroglyph. It might not look like much, but it simply means that man made a symbol here. The symbol here is a series of peck marks. And so that's what makes this fascinating. In other words, you know, you might be coming up here to look at a recognizable image, whereas all you see is these peck marks, dots. But the fascinating thing is that ancient man, thousands of years ago, made this image. As I said, its meaning has been lost in time, but it did have a meaning. My goodness, here's another one. Look. Okay, look at this right here. You can see a series of peck marks, one going this way, one going this way, and one going that way. Hard to say what they were trying to project, but again, another symbol left behind by ancient man. So we continue our trek, but look at this. Isn't this absolutely gorgeous? I'll tell you, there has not been one vehicle here in the last hour. This is really an isolated and beautiful spot. Well, let's go, oh my goodness. I was gonna say, let's go to the edge. Look at this over here. Look at this. Now this is really unique. This is what's called a grid pattern. Can you see the squares? Okay, can you see the squares all here? Squares all the way around. Okay, now at first glance you might think, hey, this is what we call a geofact. In other words, it's created by the stone itself. But look, you can actually see the groove marks, the incision made right over here. Here's a natural crack right here. You can see it. I mean, you can tell a natural crack. There's a natural crack. They're everywhere. But this right over here is what's called an incision. It's been incised in here. So there's this large grid pattern right here. I'll tell you, this is truly fascinating. Well, let's get to the top of this boulder, and you can see what it looks like from here. I'll tell you, I really, really feel a sense of joy, not only in the natural beauty, but finding the symbols of ancient man. Well, friends, we're just recently on top of that boulder area. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna come around, and right at the bottom of this top area, right at the bottom is where we saw the circular symbols and the scratch marks. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna continue to search along this boulder, the top of the boulder, to see if we can see any more symbols of ancient man. Right over here you can see the boulder has split. So there's two splits, okay, the first one behind me, and then here's the other one. So this rock, let's say it contains, or right now, so far, three different pieces that we can tell. Anyways, as I'm walking along, oh my goodness, look at this. Okay, you might not be able to discern much, but again, here's a symbol. Okay, you can see the peck marks, okay? And here's a little cupule. See, it came here to this point. There's a cupule. And it continues, goes this way, follow my hand. Okay, here's the pecking right there. Can you see it? I'll tell you, this is a series of wavy lines and circular patterns. And oh my goodness, right over here, here's another circular area that comes up over here. And I see another one. Now again, this is interesting. Look at this, it's circular right here, with a line through there. This here, again, is a fertility symbol. It's sought to represent the vulva, and perhaps they had ceremonies here, coming of age, fertility rites. So possibly this area was also a worship site. But anyways, my goodness, look at this right here. This is fairly deep over here, again. Another series of what we call curvilinear, in other words, a straight line, and then it curves, and it curves over here. Again, people would call this archaic, refer to it as abstract. And there's another one right over here. Look at this right here. Look at this. This almost has a square pattern here, so it's part grid. And then there's a line going out here, radiating out to here. And as we continue to look and follow it, look at this. It keeps on running. Okay, here's some more symbols again over here. and then right over here, then right over there, and again right over here. Look at this. All right, series of circular patterns with a line running down over here. Look at this. My goodness, quite a bit of stuff going on over here. Let's follow the boulder. Let's see if we can find any other symbols. I'm sure there are some here. Again, you can see the natural configuration of the boulder right below you, and you can use this image in your mind to compare it to when we get to what is a petroglyph. This is very interesting again, very subtle, but here it is. You can see the peck marks, so it's kind of oval shaped, and the peck mark continues up here, right up here. I'll tell you, this is truly fascinating. Let me see if I can find any more symbols. Oh my goodness, this is very interesting. Look at this one here. Looks like a series of circles right here. And right in the center, the dot, the cupule. So hopefully you can see these series. I think there's two rings. It could even be a spiral, hard to say. It's either a circle or spiral pattern right here in front of us. Let's continue looking. Let me go further down this boulder. Now you can see some lichen right here under our feet, and this could very well be covering up many petroglyphs. Hard to say. So let me show you something interesting right here, because this site was thought to be a quarry site. So you can see right over here there's a big chunk missing. But look at this over here. They look like chisel marks. Okay, and what the ancients would do is they would use a hard stone to work the soft stone. This blue schist here is very soft. So what they did is they would create a circular pattern or pattern like this here and work it by pecking away and create a raised area right over here. And they would call these pecked curvilinear nucleated petroglyphs. A lot of words. But anyways, once they excavated the outer channel, so to speak, it would create an outer channel. And so in the center would be a big, we'll call it a bulbous piece. And then they would knock it off. And they would take this center piece and work it into a charm stone or even jewelry. And there has been cases where this blue schist was used to make arrow straighteners. I'll tell you, this is truly fantastic. To me, this doesn't look like a natural occurrence. It seems to me that right here, there was an effort to lift off a bigger piece. This is truly fantastic. We just spoke about these pecked curvilinear nucleated petroglyphs, and I found a perfect example over here. This one's incomplete. In other words, you can see the peck marks right over here. You see it right here going all around, creating this elevated 3D bulbous piece of rock. Now, once this was done, an effort was made to hit it right over here and break off a beautiful chunk over here, which later on would be sanded down and worked into what's called a charm stone. And I know there's cases where they were made into arrow shaft straighteners and also jewelry. But look over here, as I'm looking further on, I see another potential PCN right over here. Look at this. I'll tell you, here's another PCN right here. Okay, there's one there. And look, there's an effort over there. This is truly fascinating. I'll tell you, these are very, very old. So we see one, two, three, possibly a fourth right over here. And you see that area that's, I'll call it vacant or empty, right over here. There could have been a piece that was actually right here. You can actually look, this is a mined one. You can see the peck marks forming the circular pattern. And you can see this piece is gone. So it's been knocked off to give a nice chunk. Here's another one. Oh my goodness. So this is another effort to make a PCN right here. And I'll tell you, this is truly fascinating. So perhaps this whole boulder yielded these what we'll call pecked, curvilinear, nucleated petroglyphs, but the object being to create this piece right here to later on knock off. Well, friends, what I've done is climbed off this large, beautiful blue schist boulder outcrop. And I'm walking down here on the backside, so to speak, to see if I can find any symbols here along the walls here. It's covered with lichen, and we're looking at it in its natural state. So this is important. Take a look. This is the natural state we're looking at right now. And once you've attuned yourself to what the natural state looks like, you'll be able then, later on, to tell if something has been altered, either, I guess, by nature possibly, but more than likely by man. So, oh my goodness, look, okay, here's exactly what I'm talking about. Look at this right here, okay, natural, this is what it should look like. We're going down, look at this. This, my friends, is a quarried area. Look at this. This here has been lopped off right over here to take this chunk out. So more than likely, as I said, this has been altered by man. This is a quarried piece. Well, friends, I have something really fascinating to share with you. We just had a short discussion about trying to identify petroglyphs and signs of ancient man, with the first step being to look at what the natural elements look like. I'm going to show you this here for a reason. This is what this boulder looks like as it ages and it sloughs off right here. You see this? Every stone here, every piece of blue schist here has a 90 degree angle to it. So this is the natural way, the natural setting for the stone to break away. Well, right up over here, let me show you. I'll climb up right here, is where I talked about the pecked curvilinear nucleated petroglyphs, right up over here. You remember they were created by pecking or incising the stone right here like this as an element to knock off a piece right here like this to create a charm stone or some other type of implement. What I'm going to do is we're going to go back up there and take a real close look at these PCN petroglyphs. And so let's go up there and take another close look. Right here is a good example. Again, this is a PCN. You can see where there was pecking around here. Sometimes it's abrasion. And then the idea is to break it off right here at an angle to get a full piece, okay, to make another implement, a charm stone or a jewelry or an arrow shaft straightener. So right over here is another series of PCNs. Right over there is the stone area that I told you to take a look at, the natural breaking of the stone. Every stone has a 90 degree angle. So I'm showing you this for a reason. Right here we have the bottom. I'm going to show you what I found at the bottom over here. And I'd passed it several times, but when I looked down, I could see that this object that I found below me was not natural. It had elements where man had altered it. So let's go take a look, okay? So here we go. Again, this is the petroglyph area. And right up above us, right over there, is where the PCNs were. Okay, follow this down to this area right here. This, my friends, over here, is the result of a PCN effort. Right over here, look at this stone. This is, again, blue schist. You can actually see peck marks on this stone. You can actually see them. This is the result of carving out a PCN petroglyph to create a stone, a circular patterned stone, to make a charm stone or any other implement that you wanted to make. So this is truly fascinating. This object over here is the result of trying to make a PCN petroglyph with the object of taking out this nucleated, this raised area that you've carved a channel around. This is it. This is the result. This is the type of stone you'll get. And what's fascinating about this stone, if you look at it real closely, you can still see the pecking marks around the stone. To find this right here is, I tell you, it's incredible. It's incredible to find this piece right here at a PCN spot. Almost impossible, I tell you, because much of this history, much of this knowledge, much has been lost in time. Now, one of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to take that stone and leave it here. I'm not going to leave it right there, but I'm going to put it in a place where it'll be safe, hopefully for time immemorial. It'll rest here with the ancients. Again, as I said, this is truly, truly fascinating, and we're very fortunate to have been able to see this outcrop, to find this PCN piece. It's almost impossible, I tell you. This is truly, again, I hope I'm not sounding like a broken record, but this is exciting and truly fantastic. And so, I bid farewell to this fantastic spot, lost in time, but hopefully through this small vignette that we've experienced right now, we can bring back some of the elements of the past for knowledge today.